Yes. This is the second instrument from this chapter. I mean, you might have already used moving coil calorimeter, and in the previous chapter also, you had that jockey calorimeter to find the null point, right? So right now we are getting inside the calorimeter and seeing how it is made. Okay. So inside calorimeter, this is how it looks.
Rotation
is proportional to the amount of current in the coil. Understood? So suppose number of turns is N, current is I, and magnetic field is B, and torsional spring constant is K. Then what is the equation? Equation is like this: N I A B. This is the torque. Okay. When this torque equals to K times phi, phi is the amount of rotation, then it will not rotate. Write it down.
Okay. Yeah.
All of you write this down. Phi is the angle of rotation. Now you can see that angle of rotation is directly proportional to the current. Okay, and the thing inside the bracket, it depends on the galvanometer, inside the galvanometer what it is. Okay, current is outside, it comes from outside. But whatever inside the bracket, it is for a galvanometer. So it is called galvanometer constant. Write it down. It's a very sensitive device. Even if it is, even if a slight amount of current is passed, it will immediately show the deflection. Okay? And deflection is created because of this. Magnet is there, magnetic field is there, and current creates magnetic dipole moment. So that into B is the magnetic torque. On that principle, moving coil galvanometer works. Any doubt? No doubts? Okay. So now see, the from the last chapter, a small part is left, which we can finish now itself. Because how much time is there? We have 30 minutes, good amount of time there. So let's finish this topic, because these kind of questions are very common in CET and JEE Mains, that they will ask you to convert galvanometer into voltmeter, voltmeter into ammeter, and things like that. Okay? Okay. In fact, in your book, this topic is there in this chapter itself, moving charge and magnetism. It should be in the previous chapter. Anyways, they are converting galvanometer into an ammeter and then galvanometer into a voltmeter. Fine. All of you write down voltmeter. Into an ammeter.
A voltmeter to ammeter.
Suppose this is your voltmeter V. It has a very large resistance, yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, how the voltmeter works? It has a dial like this. Okay, it will have readings like 1 volt, 2 volt, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, let's say. It has these readings, and the pointer will rotate, and it will show you that the pointer is, let's say, at point number 5. So let's say 5 volts. Okay, now if I want to convert it into ammeter, okay, then I should be measuring the current, but the readings are for volts. But if I know how many volts correspond to how many ampere, then I will be able to find out. Okay, but then here I want to make sure that the full deflection, suppose I want to convert into ammeter, I should be knowing till what range the ammeter should be. Are you getting my point? So basically, if it goes to full scale, there is something called full scale deflection. Okay? full scale deflection is a deflection after which it will not show any reading. Okay, so I should know that if I am building an emitter, I can maximum measure up to, let's say, 5 ampere. Like that. After that, this pointer doesn't move. So you will not be able to find out whether it is 5.2 or 5.5. Both of them, the pointer is stuck here. Okay, now suppose I want to build an emitter of full scale deflection for I naught. Okay, then this is how I will do. I will connect a shunt resistance of S like this, parallel. Okay, and then I will connect this in series in the circuit. This point A and B will be connected in series. Understood? Now I am measuring maximum current I naught. So I naught will be where? Where in the circuit? Where it will be?
Through V.
This? Not through the shunt.
No, through V.
This is I naught.
No.
Okay. Now let us say this voltmeter shows full deflection for small I current.
Then I should pass through.
Then only small I should pass through here. Because full scale deflection of this voltmeter will correspond to full scale deflection of I naught. So how much current will go there?
I naught minus
I S. Bhai, junction rule, na? And then if you apply a loop rule over this, or you can say that this and that resistance are in parallel. So I naught minus I times S will be equal to I times R.
Sir, should we also account for the internal resistance of the voltmeter itself?
That's what it is. This R is inside what?
Oh, okay.
Okay. So you will get a value of how much shunt resistance you should connect like this. Understood? Okay. Now suppose I am converting emitter into voltmeter. Okay. Or let's try to do this because all these methods are same. Let's convert galvanometer into voltmeter. The way we do it is the same. Okay. So galvanometer will also have a full scale deflection for the corresponding current. Yes or no? Okay. So same thing. So let's say you have a galvanometer like this. It has a resistance of let's say RG. This is your galvanometer. Okay. You want to use it like a voltmeter. Then you need to connect a large resistance, capital R, in series. Okay. And then you have to connect this across two points where you want to measure the potential difference. Okay. Now, if full scale deflection for galvanometer is small I, for small I current, galvanometer shows the full deflection. Alright? Then till what potential you can measure from A to B?
I into R plus R.
I into RG plus R. This is the maximum possible potential difference which you can measure. Getting it? So you can increase this range by increasing this resistance itself. Because if more than this current goes to the galvanometer, the pointer won't move. That corresponds to the maximum deflection. Understood? Okay? So whenever such question comes, do not use a final expression. Try to apply some logic and solve it, because if it is coming in JEE, definitely they will not give you direct form of substitution. Okay, so that's all about this chapter theory. Okay, we have to do lots and lots of problem practice, and this is a very easy chapter. We have to make sure we score 100% in this chapter. Definitely, you know, two questions in JEE Advanced, not two, one big mark question, as in at least 6-7 marks or 10 marks probably, will come from this chapter itself. Okay.
One passage based on one big multi correct.
Could be. Okay, what I'm trying to say is the weightage is not small. There is another chapter on magnetism which is EMI. Okay, which is also very simple. Magnetism, all chapters are simple, straightforward. So make sure you hit hard where it matters the most.